Students, today let us solve one problem with regard to the bail mate, which has been given in the Karnataka State Law University law exams. That is, here this problem is normally, it will be given in the Karnataka State Law University exams. So here, I used to tell you that how we should solve the problem. That means here, if we solve the problem in a such a way that it should cover all the legal aspects and legal components, then it would be very much the answer would be deserved to get the good marks. So here we have to cover the facts, issue, analysis and conclusion. So this method we have to follow with regard to the writing our answers with regard to the problem solving. Here in my all my videos, I am covering the majority of the problems which has been given from the beginning of the Karnataka State Law University. That means from 2011 up to 2011, I am going to solve the almost all the problems which has been given in the Karnataka State Law University law exams. So here in this problem, we can see that Sharath, an old customer, went into a restaurant for the purpose of dining there. When he entered the dining room, the waiter took his coat without being asked and hung it on a hook behind him. When Sharath rose to leave the restaurant, coat was missing. Who is liable, decide. That means it has been very much plainly, very simple, in a very simple language it has been given. Here we should know the methods for problem solving. So I used to tell you that we have to solve the problem in this way. That is fact, issue, rule, analysis, conclusion method. Then it will be our answer is deserved to get the what you call good marks. So here we have to simplify the facts. Here I have simplified in this way. Sharath, the old customer, used to go for a dining for a particular hotel. That means he is the customer of a hotel. One day when Sharath entered the hotel, the waiter took the coat of Sharath and hung it on a hook, that is behind him. So that out of a courtesy the waiter might have done it. When Sharath was leaving the hotel, his coat was missing. So these are all the facts of the case. So when we see this what you call the problem, what are all the issues will be framed, what are all the issues will come between the plaintiff and defendant. Here, who is the plaintiff? Plaintiff is the Sharath, that is the customer. Who is the defendant? The restaurant owner. Here, what we have to see, we have to frame the issues. That means, well, I have told you, I used to tell you with regard to the importance of the issue. That means answering the problem, we have to frame one issue or more than one issues. So that means if the problem attracts you to write more issues, you can write here what are the issues will arise here, whether the restaurant keeper was the bailee of the court. Here you should know what is meant by bailor, what is meant by bailee, and you should know the sections under bailment with regard to the bailment. That means if you know the law, then you could be able to answer these sort of the problems. That means you should know here, while framing the issues, you should know certain amount of the law knowledge also. Here, whether the restaurant keeper was the bailee of the court. You know who is the bailor and who is the bailee. So next one is whether there is any negligence on the part of the plaintiff. That is, who is the plaintiff? It is the bailor, that is Sharath, who went to the hotel for dining, and whether the waiter did it in the course of his duty. That means whether the waiter used to do this act of taking the coat from the customer and hang it on the hook. whether the waiter, this act of the waiter, whether it will come under the normal course of his duty or whether it is a out of courtesy. That means here all these issues, the court have to resolve it. So here we have to raise the issues. When we analyze the facts of the case, we should be in a position to raise the issues. That is very much simple. That means when you read the problem, you could be able to write the issues. Here, then we have to write the provision of law. So where we can find this provision of law, we can see under the bailment under the Contract Act. That is 148 and 149 section. And with regard to the facts of the case, we can see the similar facts of the case in the Woolsey versus Nicholas case law and also Holder versus Saul B. And certain principles which were with regard to bailment, we can see even under Richards versus Brington and South Coast Railway Company. That means here, while answering the problem solving questions, you should have certain knowledge of the legal concepts and you should know the case laws. So these are all the provision of law. Now we have simplified the facts, we have drawn the issues, now we have discussed with regard to the which provision of law will be applicable here. Here we have to write the either sections and or the articles, or if articles or sections are not there, we have to write the principles, and we have to write the decided case laws, if any. That is, it is not compulsory. With regard to certain problems, there will not be any decided case laws also. That means it's not compulsory. If there is any decided case law is there, then you will be comfortable in writing the what would be the correct answer. So these are all the steps we have to follow while answering the problem solving questions. So we have to follow this FIRSA method or IRSA method and ILASA method. So many methods are there, but I am adopting this FIRSA method only. So here what we have to do, then we have to analyze it. So we have to go for analysis, then ultimately we have to go for conclusion, or we can write it a decision or reason for decision making. Either this one or that one, both are one and the same. If you write decision and reason for decision making, we have to write entire thing with regard to the reasons for the decision making. If you write only decision or conclusion, we can say, we can write yes or no. That means here, in this way, we have to write in order to get the marks. So let us analyze what is the provision of law which is applicable here, and what are all the issues, and what are all the facts of the case. Let us discuss under the analysis section. And I should tell you what are all the things has to be discussed under the analysis section. That is facts, issues, and the provision of law. Here, section 148 of the Indian Contract Act 1872 defines bailments as follows. Section 148A defines that bailment is the, section 148 says a bailment is the delivery of the goods by one person to another. Here, once 148, what it says, a bailment is the delivery of the goods by one person to another for some purpose upon a contract that they shall, when the purpose is accomplished, be returned or otherwise disposed of according to the directions of the person delivering them. So this is what we can see under section 148. So here the person delivering the goods is called the bailer, and the person to whom they are delivered is called the bailee. So these are the provision of law. You know who can be called as the bailee, who can be called as the bailer. That means the person who delivers the goods is called the bailer. The person who receives the goods is called as the bailee. So these things we know with regard to which what are the facts of the case. So here, when we know the facts of the case, here we have to discuss what is the question of law, what is the question of fact. So we have to analyze the question of law and the question of fact with regard to the present case. So here we have to see whether there is an existence of a bailment. So whether there is an existence of a bailment, because when the bailer has delivered the goods to the bailee, it is his what you call, it is his responsibility of a bailee to return the goods to the bailer. So here we have to see, is there any existence of the bailment? Here, how it can be determined? So here the aspect can be determined that whether the defendant has got the control over the article in question. Whether the defendant has got the control over the article in question. And is there any negligence on the part of the bailee? If the same has not been returned by the bailee, if there is any negligence is there. So this will be, this aspect will be held, it will be the important component of the bailment. If he is negligent and if he is having the control over the article in question, then defendant will be held liable. Here, in the present case, what we have to see, the waiter, whether he had acted in courtesy to a customer in the restaurant or otherwise. Here, what happened? Here, the waiter took the coat in his possession. That means, when the Sharat entered the hotel, the waiter, he has taken the control of the coat in his possession. Thereby, Sharat had been relieved of the coat, of its care. That means, he is relieved of the care of the coat. Thus, what we can see, where waiter took on the responsibility of a bailee. So, once the customer has been relieved with regard to his article, the waiter, he has taken the responsibility as a bailee. So, it was the waiter who selected the place where the coat should be hung. And here, the customer has not given any direction. So, therefore, the restaurant keeper was held liable for this loss of the coat. So, let us see the other turn. Suppose the customer had given directions. So, if the customer has given the directions with regard to where the coat should be hung. So, if he gives the directions and with regard to where the coat should be hung. So, at that time, if the customer has instructed the waiter where and how the coat should be hung, the relationship between the customer Sharat and the restaurant owner, the relationship should be otherwise. It may become the license arrangement. So what happens when we go to any mall? So when we go to any mall, what we will do, if we go in a car, we can park the car in a mall. So if the car has been stolen, whether the mall owner could be held responsible? Because here, this is the question. That means, a person will go to the mall, but he's having total control, because he has parked the car in the premises of the mall, and he's having the key. That means, probably you know with regard to what is meant by constructive possession and all those things, you know. Here, even though the car has been parked in the premises of the mall, which has been owned by some other person, but it is under the control of the plaintiff. Even though it is under the premises of the defendant, the control is still with the plaintiff because he is having the keys with him. Here, whether the mall owner could be held responsible in this case means he could not be held responsible, because there will not be any concept of existence of the bailment. So this aspect we have to see. So otherwise, that's why here we have to see whether there is any existence of bailment or not. So when there is an existence of bailment is there, then automatically the bailee will be held responsible. Here, similar to this case law, there are other case laws also there. Here, similar to this case law, there is one more case law is there, that is Holder versus Sol B. Here also, the court has held that there was ample evidence of a bailment of the coat. The waiter took the coat without being asked by the plaintiff to do so and hung it up. So, here the jury, that is a judge, has inferred that he offered to take the coat and he did so in the ordinary course of his duty as a servant of the defendant. So the restaurant keeper was justified in his finding that he took it out to the plaintiff for possession into his own care and the course of his duty to the defendant. Here, the restaurant keeper, he justifies that with regard to finding that he took it out of the plaintiff's possession, the court, into its own care, that is defendant's care, and which was in the course of his duty, that is, it is the course of the duty of the defendant. So, there existing the concept of bailment. So, when there is a concept of bailment is there, it is the duty of the bailee to return the goods which has to be given to the plaintiff, that is bailer. So, what should be our conclusion? The conclusion is that in the instant case, the waiter took on the responsibility of a bailee. That means here, waiter includes the restaurant owner also. Here, the restaurant waiter is acting on behalf of the restaurant owner. And further, it was the waiter who selected the place where the court should be hung without the directions from the customer Sharad. So, the restaurant keeper held liable for the loss of the court. So, in this way, we have to solve the case. So, here, with regard to this case, so there is a slight different view has been adopted by the court in the case of Kali Perumal Pillai versus Vishalakshi. So, here, the court has given a different view with regard to the case law of Kali Perumal Pillai versus Vishalakshi. So, we can see that aspect in the other class. So, here what we have to do, we have to solve the problems. That means, how the problem has been looked by the court. Here, even though there are similar problems, there are so many problems there with regard to the same concept. So, we should know how to solve the problem. Here, what is the important thing? We should know the law. We should have certain amount of knowledge with regard to the case laws. So, that is the very important thing. Otherwise, if the students, the right generally, normally, I used to say that majority of the students, that is 90 to 95% of the students, they used to solve the problems in the general way, in the essay type of answers they will write. Whatever they happily they want to write, they will write. Even pages together, number of pages they used to write with regard to the solving the problems. So they straight away they jump into the conclusion. And they will decide whether the restaurant owner is liable or not, whether the Sharad he can get the compensation or not. So they will write, they will use the language of with regard to the some other law also. They may use the language of the tort subject also. So that is the, and they used to use the language of general language. So here, being the law students, what we have to do? We have to use the legal language even while answering the questions. Here, there is no scope for writing the answers in the general way. Even you write a number of pages, you don't get the marks. That is the problem why the students are scoring very less marks, very minimum marks. So that's why students, you try to solve all the problems, not only this subject. You solve almost all the subjects. So that you can score good marks with regard to the scoring the good marks with regard to the problem solving. So this is with regard to the bailment concept. In the next class, we can see the case law with regard to the Kalai Perumal Pillai versus Vishalakshi.